Hi. So as you've heard, it's been more than 50 years that AI has had the aspiration of a machine that starts like a baby and learns like a child. So if it's taken more than 50 years, what's so hard about that? Well, you have to know how babies start and how they learn, where human knowledge comes from. And there's one wrong hypothesis that is so intuitive, it has appealed to philosophers for thousands of years. Here, a baby starts with a booming, buzzing confusion. Sensations, lights, colors, motions, sounds, millions of meaningless bits of experience. And these tiny pieces accumulate slowly to add up, eventually, statistically, to the bigger picture. This idea is so tempting because it's the part of learning we notice, the sensations, the repetitions, the putting two and two together. But as Laura just showed you, this idea vastly underestimates the sophistication of children's learning, the hypothesis testing, the creativity, the generativity. It also underestimates how babies start in at least two key ways. Babies start not just with sensations, but with expectations. And they don't just passively receive input, but actively seek and select the input that they need. Faces are a great example. Babies are not born knowing exactly what a face looks like, of course, but they are born with a rough expectation. If you show a baby an image like the one at the top, she will follow the motion with her eyes, even literally the day she is born. But she won't follow a similarly complex image like the one at the bottom, or even like this one, where the only change is the color inside the eyes. Now, it's hard for us to imagine what it would feel like to be this baby, just one day old, with no experience, very poor vision, literally not even enough input to be confused, and yet feel drawn, pulled, to look at and learn from and get attached to and remember anything that looks like this, details to be filled in later. So babies start with rough expectations built into the innate architecture of their brain. We can test this idea directly by measuring the development of their brains. Now, in human adults, multiple patches of cortex are set aside, devoted to the problem of seeing human faces. And we can study how this process develops in a human's brain. Now, this is the MRI machine in my lab down the street, where we study how this process unfolds. This multi-million dollar machine has a custom-built infant coil that we designed to let a baby lie comfortably in the scanner while we took the first ever MRI images of the baby's brain while they looked at faces. Now, as many of you know, an MRI can provide an exquisitely detailed image of activity in each square millimeter of the brain while they watch movies of friendly children's faces or of their neighborhoods. The only thing is how to get the baby to lie exactly, perfectly still, moving less than a millimeter while we collect the data. So scaling these experiments to babies took some work. But we did, and we discovered something remarkable. If a baby's mind was a booming, buzzing confusion, and making sense of the world took lots of time to learn, you would expect this organized pattern of activity would not show up until kids were much older. But in 4 to 6 month old babies, we saw exactly the same brain regions, already more active when a baby looked at faces than when they looked at natural environments. Because patterns of brain connectivity already exist in infants' brains that make the faces different. So babies start not just with sensations, but with expectations. And these expectations drive active learning, choosing what to look at and who to learn from. Young babies don't just prefer faces. They prefer to look at and learn from attentive and affectionate interaction partners. For example, they look more at a person who is speaking in baby talk with high pitch and wide smiles like this.
Gacy fawo namu, mufa nasi gewo.
Compared to regular adult speech.
Budo la pakuti.
Even though both people are saying the same patterns of the same syllables, the same nonsense syllables. And we can test how this works in the brain, too, using a different technology, near-infrared spectroscopy, that sits in a lightweight cap on a baby's head, so that we can measure brain activity while the baby sits up to play with a toy or even have an interaction. And this lets us measure, this lets us measure activity in a different region, a frontal cortex, a region that in adults is most active for valuable and self-relevant social interactions. And in six-month-old babies, this frontal region already does the same job. It shows more activity for a person who is affectionate and attentive, whether by smiling and talking to the baby, or in other experiments following the baby's attention or calling their attention or calling their name. The frontal region also responds more to images of the baby's own parent than even to a friendly stranger. And this is the coolest part. So later, the baby sees the same two people, but now neither of them is speaking and both is smiling. And even so, babies prefer to look at the person who was friendly earlier, as if expecting to learn more from them. And the frontal region, the more the frontal cortex responded to the person in the earlier initial phase, the more the babies will look at that person later. So we can use activity in this brain region to predict who they will look from and who they will learn from. And this difference shows up in their learning. So babies learn, although both speakers said the same number and pattern of syllables, babies learn the pattern of syllables much better from the friendly speaker. So how do babies start? Babies start with expectations and with preferences. Babies' brains prioritize images that look like faces, and babies look at faces in order to engage in contingent, meaningful, and rewarding social interactions. The connections between babies' brains are already set up expecting this pattern of experience, a face that goes with other signals of an attentive and affectionate partner. These connections are how the brain uses its expectations to interpret its sensations and to seek the information it needs. So if you want AI that starts like a baby, you want AI that not only learns from the input it gets, but also knows what kind of inputs it is looking for, and can select what it learns and from whom. The architecture of a baby's brain is social right from the start. Thank you.